It's a new month.
It's gonna be May.
Little engine go, bin 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 go. I'm losing control. Heroin and blow, Marilyn Monroe. Overdid the dose. Time to rip with pro. Up the in dough, like a wind window. Little engine go, little engine go.
Good luck, everybody else.
Oh, Mr. Brown. You talked all that smack online about how Trapt is one of the best rock bands to ever live, one of the most streamed rock bands ever, and then you come back and make a, what sounded like a country song type kind of thing, and you announce your new album coming out in June that, frankly, I don't think anybody gives a shit about, I'm sorry to tell you. And wouldn't you know that he is still out for blood on Facebook and Twitter. Like I said, I'm gonna ignore the political shit, because if he wants to get political, that's fine. Anybody involved in politics tends to be an asshole at some point, because it's just about trying to win an argument when there really is no winner of the argument. It's more opinionative. But there are people that, you know, tell him, well, hey, you know, your band has just carried off that one song, and the reason your Spotify streams are so high and whatnot and Pandora streams are so high is because when that song, Headstrong, comes on, people are like, oh, I know this song, I like this song, and they listen to it, but really, they're on like a Shine Down radio or a Three Doors Down radio. They could care less about any of the other songs that you play, because then they're just going to skip through it. There was a thing on Facebook, I don't necessarily know what it was, but he posted it, and it said it was against their community standards. So Mr. Trapt official had this to say to the, I guess, admin of this Facebook group, saying, Daniel Adkins, I repeat, as long as you live, your music will do nothing and you will always be a pathetic amateur who needs to find a more realistic career path. You have not and will never make it music. You are a loser and you come from a long line of losers. This is why you are so bitter. I mean, if you're gonna tell somebody off, first of all, learn English. I mean, and will never make it music. You're missing a couple of words there, buddy, and some punctuation. Plus, I mean, you're talking about him being a pathetic amateur who needs to find a realistic career path? I mean, look who's talking, buddy. Look who's talking. You haven't been a big thing since 2002, 2003, since Headstrong came out. After that, nobody could really give a shit about you. And I don't understand why he thinks that everything that's said by people has to be, you know, taken as personal as it is. Yes, there are trolls on the internet, but you know, when you keep feeding the trolls more, obviously they're gonna keep popping up. The goal is to learn to ignore the trolls. Don't listen to what they say, because in the end there are people out there that support you and will follow you with what you do, but you just keep feeding the trolls. And here's more tweets that I just came across that seemed pretty weird. He said, basically, here is the deal. Trapt fans make more money than the average human being. They have better sex relationships with the opposite sex and the same sex, and they love their country, pretty much the best God ever created. I'm glad he put and the same sex. That way he lets us know he is very pro-LGBT. But also, where's the facts? Where's the statistics that show that your fans make more money than the average human being and have better relationships? I'm not saying they don't. But you just saying that doesn't make it true. Is there like a chart or something? Did you calculate this somehow? Did you like take a survey of your fans compared to other fans of other bands? Or was this just something that came off the top of your head because you couldn't come up with a good insult or a good comeback to so-called win this argument? And I like the comment posted below. He said, not M. Bison posted, Trapt fans? You mean all five of them? I mean, bro, his roast skit follow-up with him getting roasted. He has this one here. The new Trapt album, Shadow Work, is the best piece of music Trapt has ever put out, and probably one of the top five albums that will ever exist of all time. And then Jason Catcher responded to it saying, I don't even need to hear it, and I can name 10 albums already better than it. Hashtag stay humble. See what I mean? Like, it's embarrassing that your Twitter comments are better roasters than you are with these things. And then this last one that I have, I don't necessarily know what's going on here, but he just kind of rambles on for a little while. He says, if all you nerds are proud to be nerds, why you get so triggered when I call you what you already identify as. Oh, and let me say this, not all gamers are nerds, and not all nerds are gamers. Let's go ahead and end that stereotype. Hope you all are having a terrific day. I can't tell in this tweet if you're coming off as a Chad or a closeted nerd, because obviously you're the one who hates the word nerd because you're using it so much, and then you go on to say, hey, I mean, not all gamers are nerds, and not all nerds are gamers, this, that, and the other, which would lead me to think that you've been called this so much that you are trying to justify yourself, and there's nothing wrong with being a nerd either, but you also come off as a Chad because you're like, you sound like the type of person that would bully the nerdy kids just because, you know, you were, you know, an only child who got spoiled with daddy's and mommy's money and, you know, didn't get disciplined when he needed to. It's just, I don't know, like, can we seriously check on Chris Brown? Yes, that's his name, Chris Brown, of course it is. Can we just check up on him, see if he's doing okay? Because I've seen people go on Twitter rants before, but it has never been anything like this. Like, usually something like this will last for like a month and then it'll die off, but this has been going on for a while, and it's just like, I don't understand, other than the political thing, you know, he's voting for Trump, I get it, whatever, but aside from that, when he's not doing the political thing, he just seems to be belittling the people that hate or criticize him. And look, I get that there's haters out there, but then when people critique and criticize, those are the people that, you know, you can't necessarily go off on, because there's a thing called constructive criticism, and if you can't take criticism for what it is, well then I don't know why you do what you do, because you should know by now that in the music industry, you're not going to have a 100% following. Not everyone in the world is going to like you, is going to follow you. Everybody has their own preferences and, you know, whatnot. And plus, your music was never that good in the first place. Everybody kind of figured you'd be one of those one-hit wonder bands, because by the time you had your one new metal hit, that genre kind of was not necessarily dying off, but wasn't hitting the mainstream as much as it once was. You got desperate in changing your sound so many times, and nothing worked, and now you're trying to back it all up, saying, we've had plenty of hits after Headstrong, which I don't think so. I mean, I can't think of another song you had that charted on any Billboard list past that. It really is sad, because nobody was talking about Trapt until all of this came up, and I know what you're thinking. Well, I mean, you are talking about him, maybe that was the goal, but, you know, people are talking about Trapt for the worst, not for the best. You know, people aren't going to look at this and go, oh, this is fun, I should listen to Trapt. No, people are going to look at this and be like, wow, what a dickhead. Now I don't even want to touch his music. I don't even want to listen to Headstrong anymore. Or people who've never heard him, like, okay, well, I just don't want to listen to it at all, because if he's going to be that stuck up and pretentious, then that must be a warning sign to stay away from their music. I don't know. That's just my thought on this. I'm not going to play the song, too, that I mentioned earlier in the video, because he has a tendency to take some stuff down when you play little clips of it. But I can definitely tell you, it is a country twang, and you went from, oh, we're going to be a hardcore rock band, to that. You talked the talk, but you couldn't walk the walk, mister. I was maybe going into it listening, I was like, maybe they'll wow me. Maybe he was right. Maybe this will be the best thing they put out, and I'm just listening and go, oh, you sound like Aaron Lewis during his solo career, but worse. It's just like, oh boy. Anyway, hope you guys are staying safe out there. Remember, wash your damn hands. And, you know, stay away from toxic people. But until then, I will see you guys in the next one.